hate puppies. Good podcast.
I feel threatened.
It's time for a river house.
Going with that. What's going on, everybody? Welcome to Inside the Pallet House. Here's hoping you've had a good week. Thank you for joining us. As always, Inside the Pallet House. only podcast dedicated to solving first world problems. Or just drinking beer. I haven't quite figured out.
Are we still
exactly
the number one sports podcast in Richmond?
In Richmond, we are.
Okay, makes sense.
Yes, thank goodness.
Yeah.
It's a very important award.
It is.
Very prestigious award.
Yeah.
Especially for the town that has no sports.
Fragile.
And a bunch of guys who rarely talk about sports on the air. I mean, I guess we could. The closest thing to sports in my world right now, Jay Cutler's got a new, meat line.
Yeah. I'm so into sports that I don't pay attention to any bar stool other than pizza reviews. That's how into sports I am.
I do love those pizza
reviews.
They are.
I don't know what it is. I find myself at 1 a.m. and I'm like, why am I watching this dumb shit? The 40th one in a row. I could be asleep right now.
Yeah, but you got to know what the best pizza in Connecticut is, you know?
Well, the best one I liked was when the lady said, come back. You know, she challenged him to come back because he didn't pick up the right pizza.
Yeah.
I thought that was hilarious. She's like, no, this is the one you got to try.
Yeah.
How'd that go for her?
The same.
Yeah, exactly right. He doesn't really deviate. He's got a bit of an ego.
Oh, yeah. Nah, you think?
A little bit.
Tiny.
El Presidente.
Yeah.
He
is funny as shit, though.
Oh, yeah. No, he's great. I just hope he can hold it together for a while, you know? If anyone doesn't know, we're talking about Dave Portnoy from Barstool Sports.
Yeah.
El Presidente, the main guy. A guy who made a career off of basically titty jokes and being annoying and talking about sports. In fact, I feel like we got a shot here.
I do too.
If that's the formula, we're winning.
Yeah.
Yeah, but if you ever heard what he did or where he came from, like printing him off himself and going into the subway and handing them out to people forever, that's how he got started.
Damn. Flyers that said Barstool Sports.
And making stuff up and writing and doing these articles on his own and printing them out and just handing them out to people, legitimately grinding to get it going to where it was.
Oh, so his blog wasn't even necessarily in the internet. He would hand out his blog,
yes,
check this out,
that's
is hilarious.
How he started out. Yes.
See, how can you not respect hustle like that?
Yes.
But didn't he start out when it was just, there was no internet, right?
Right.
Yeah, he was just doing a little flyer.
Yeah, yeah.
Good. There used to be this thing in Chicago called the Heckler, and it was just it was the Onion for Chicago sports, and they would just make up stuff and rag people. And that's how you would get it. It would just be for free in random places, and people would be handing it out. And some of those guys have gone on to actually make careers of themselves, because if you can write enough funny jokes, then you got picked up by, wherever, probably a bar stool. Mm-hmm. But now the Heckler has its own website, and of course it doesn't do Barstool numbers.
Yeah.
That's for sure. Damn. They embrace the internet really quickly and podcast really quickly.
Yeah.
Which they've nailed it. Actually, that's the only sports podcast I listen to outside.
Oh, really?
Outside of this is Pardon My Take.
Okay.
I love that one.
That's a Barstool podcast?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. And it's all because this guy, Big Cat, he's Chicago.
Okay, gotcha.
But then the other guy that's on their PFT, he's a DC guy. So it's it's kind of funny. It's I hear these same arguments every day. So, and they're just better at it.
Yeah, exactly.
So makes me laugh.
Damn.
For sure.
Nice.
You guys enjoying this weather, though? This is crazy. We've had a spring that's crazy.
There you go, Stu. No, let's do small talk.
I'm
People
just saying.
Fucking love
just
small
saying.
Talk.
Weather
I've been
talk.
Enjoying my car like crazy.
That was that
I'm
was
sure.
Great.
Looking all cute.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm just saying, man.
Stu, how about it, the weather?
Everybody, how about it, man?
No.
I love this shit.
How about that sunlight, folks?
Yeah.
since you've been locked inside for a year.
I haven't.
Yeah. You two haven't at all.
Right.
You two have absolutely lived your life. If anyone's shocked at the sun, it's my pale skin.
I gave you the update on my taste, but that shit's still not back.
Are you serious right now?
Oh, yeah. We're talking, March, April, May, June. 4 months now.
Really?
And yeah. It's fucking weird. I mean, I should say it's not bad. It's 80%.
Do you think, though, that you're just no, I used to taste more? Or you can still tell that this is a deficiency?
Oh, I can tell that I can't taste shit. Like, there's no detail. And I was reading something about it that was like, it really is a smell issue. Because I guess without smell, you can still pick up savory, sweet, and the main things.
Yeah.
But you, the smell is what keeps you from getting the detail in it.
But
so,
aren't there things you can, like, I've read, like, aren't there things you can do to try and, like,
yeah,
retrain
like
to get
exactly.
stimulate?
Yeah, weird
get
shit,
back?
Like you stare at a lemon and smell a lemon. So you tell your brain, this is a lemon, dummy, and you smell it. Weird.
This is dog shit.
What the hell? You have to retrain yourself?
I feel
like
I'm training myself all the time, and I'm like, this is Chipotle. I know. Like, I don't need, like, I look at the shit I eat every day. Why do I need to redo it? You know what I mean? Who's eating blindfolded? No one's eating blindfolded.
How do you go about training yourself?
There's a whole thing about you can do it online.
So there's probably
it's got a name. I can't think of it off the top of my head.
Well, I mean, it's the same principle as people who have to relearn after a stroke or something, relearning to walk, eat, talk, write.
But those aren't senses. Like, if you had to relearn touch, that'd be weird.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, it's supposed to re-help with growing your nerve endings back, because that's the whole thing. Your nerve.
That's exactly
the nerve
right.
endings have to regenerate so that you get your smells and your taste back. And some people get them back in 12 days. Some people take
it's
6 months.
It's like the neuropaths are like they've gotten snow and the plow hasn't shown up yet. You know what I mean? So
okay,
you need to plow that shit out.
And you do
so
that
by
staring at lemons.
Apparently.
And inhaling deeply.
Who knew?
Wild.
Right.
Wild. Well, you won't be here for the bourbon tasting, which is great news, because you'd be picking up on notes of burning.
Right.
You'd be like, yep.
Tastes like bourbon. What's next?
I'm like, this is not doing it for me.
Right.
All that training just fried his, it's all gone.
Exactly.
I took a step back. I'm at like 60% now, son of a bitch.
It is. It's weird. It comes and goes. Sometimes I'm like, I barely tasted that shit. And I always forget, too, because I'm like, this is going to be good. And I eat it, and I'm like, you totally forgot you didn't have taste, dummy.
Still dealing with it. I am seriously shocked. I thought for sure you were back by now, because
I'm close. I would say 80-90%, but I still cannot get detail and taste.
So you never go, is that dill in there?
Never.
Like, that's the stuff.
Ever. Never.
So Chef Boyardee and good spaghetti, kind of in the same ballpark.
Yeah.
The texture's good. The red sauce.
Well, no, Chef Boyardee's got no good texture. It's all mushy. So if I get some good pasta, I'll still know that it's good
pasta.
That's
true.
Right.
But if I gave you fast food pasta... There used to be a place that did versus like a high end place. You probably
no clue.
Pretty similar.
You know what? If you don't have any taste, you can't really taste anything. I would be out entering in every single food challenge, because it wouldn't matter. You just like put it all down. Like,
well,
it wouldn't matter.
We talked about that, and that's the weird psychology thing where you would think that I wouldn't want to eat as much because I can't taste as much, but it doesn't work that way because your brain knows what something is supposed to taste like.
Okay.
So I would think, I could cut 50 pounds. I can't taste shit. But my head's like, oh, no, you still want that shit even though you can't taste it.
Yeah.
It's weird.
Have you noticed any changes in things that you prefer? I know that had not been the case months ago.
No.
So still nothing to that effect where you're like, nah, you know what? I think I'd rather have pepperoni.
Yes. No changes like that.
That's crazy, because I had a friend who his mom got in a car accident, messed her sinuses up, and then – that was it. She couldn't smell anymore. That was the ramifications of the accident. And so she actually did over time change. Like, she was like, I can eat sausage. I hate these things. Just because texture was everything to her.
Right.
And different kinds of texture she started to like.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm wondering how long that took. Because if it hasn't hit you in 4 months, then...
Oh, I feel like you would crave texture if you had no smell or taste. Like, it's the only thing that you have. It's literally all you have to differentiate something awesome.
Yeah, because, like, soups would be horrible.
Yes. You'd be like, can I get something crunchy in this bitch?
Yeah.
Yeah. Anything. Like, just put some saltines in
right.
Anything.
Yeah.
And then it's only good for the first 2 minutes, because
exactly.
then it's
sog. Right.
Dang. Well, sorry to hear that, man.
Oh, no, it's all good. I'm still fat and eating.
Way to stick to it.
Yeah.
Look at the gumption on
charging
this guy.
Charging through.
You know, the stick-to-itiveness of you. That's really impressive.
That's what I do.
I've actually gained weight.
Right. Yeah.
Not bad.
I showed this virus.
Yeah.
Yeah, you won't take me down.
I'm going to feed it. Yeah. Obesity will kill me.
Exactly.
I'll show you. Diabetes. Now, that's a killer.
Yeah.
Good job. Way to stick to your guns, Healy. Mm-hmm. Respect it.
Faux show.
You guys doing anything for Father's Day? Got anything good on the horizon?
Oh,
and happy Father's Day to all you fathers out there. Oh, Ely's got nothing on the radar.
Yeah.
No, I pivoted with my girls because for anybody that would follow me on Facebook, they've known for years and years, both my girls, every Father's Day would do, give me a mani and a pedi and do my hair and makeup. And I'd just sit there and drink a beer and let them just go crazy on me for Father's Day. That was their gift, and like have fun and makeup.
Okay, I like
so
that.
So now that they're 16 and 14, obviously they're not into that anymore. It's been probably 3 years. But we did pivot, and I booked a pedicure.
So basically,
for the three
they get a present.
Yeah,
for
they
Father's
get a pedicure.
Day.
I'm gonna go sit. I'm gonna get a pedicure too, and then we'll go out to eat and just spend some time, the three of us, for the day.
Nothing manlier than that little sentence.
That's what they like to do.
Happy Father's Day,
yeah.
Stu.
Yeah. Happy Kids Day.
Hey, it's being a girl dad.
That's not what we're doing.
Yeah, no.
I don't know.
You should be dragging them onto a golf course with you.
I'm dragging them tubing. That's not exactly crazy, but it's like
I do love tubing.
I want to go tubing. So it's like, everybody get in the truck. We're going tubing.
I love tubing. Every time I hear the word tubing, I'm like, I don't do that enough.
Well, we might be going out.
It is about as stupid simple as it gets.
So much fun. The thing that's tough with tubing, and I was talking with the wife about this, is that it's tough to take kids tubing because they can't sit still.
No.
They can't
to wait their turn?
No, they can't just float in a tube and shut the fuck up and enjoy it. They got to jump out and flip the tube
and try
to do all this cool shit. And you're like, just relax and enjoy the goddamn scenery. They don't do that. You know what I mean?
I flipped it. I was thinking powerboat.
Yeah. My favorite part of tubing is literally laying in the tube, leaning back as far as I can so my head's in upside down and looking at the world upside down and shutting the hell up.
Yeah, exactly.
That's my favorite thing. And
that's the best part about tubing is the relaxation and the quiet.
Yeah, I just lay there, look at the world upside down and float.
Everything that's not conducive for kids. So I'll be interesting to get a report from you when you come back as to how that went. If they were able to enjoy it or if it was like 20 questions.
I mean, we've taken them tubing before.
Oh,
but
really?
But I've always had the distraction of others with me. So it's like, I've never done just the family. So this will be interesting.
Right.
Now it is going to be a little different.
Just don't drown. I'll be over here floating.
That's the thing. They keep wanting to get out and swim away.
That's my point.
Go places. And it's like, all right, that's a little sketch.
Yeah.
Are you doing the same little stretch?
Yeah, I always do the same stretch. It's easy money.
Which one?
Is there islands there?
If you go out, there's a couple. If you go out to Powhatan, there's a state park. You can literally park your car there, and then if you have another car, you have that person turn around and drive out, and you dump that car at the I guess that's Maiden's Landing.
Yeah.
Maiden's boat
522.
So like there's a boat spot just around the bend, and the beauty of the Powhatan State Park is if the water's high, they have one lot called A lot, and you can put in, and it goes around a whole nother bend, and then on the other end of that bend is the C lot, and so if the water's really low, then you just put in at sea lot and do just the other bend. But so if it's fast, you can go around a bend and around a bend, or you can just do one bend.
That's awesome. So compare this experience to our typical experience from years past. Is it similar depth? Is it similar speed?
deeper.
Deeper?
A little bit deeper.
You're not, are you standing still?
Yeah, you can stand, unless the water's, pretty high.
Right.
But yeah, for the most part, you're standing. It's not as wooded. A little more clearings, but still very much the same difference. I guess the main difference being a train track rolling by.
Yeah,
but it's still a similar. It's much wider.
Is there a place, any sort of organization that has tubes up there, or do you just bring your own and roll?
There is a company that does it.
Okay.
I don't know what they are. I would assume James River Tubes.
Yeah.
Make that up.
Look that up.
Yeah.
It's not done by the park.
Gold.
Yeah.
But, they do that. And that's how I figured it all out one day is I've been looking on a map for a spot. And then somewhere in my searches, I found a company that was like, hey, we'll take you up there. And I was like, take me up there to a state park?
Yeah.
You're out.
Right.
I've got tubes. So, yeah, I'm going to force them to do that. That's
cool.
By the extent of my wife did try to pull this whole, hey, the walkway needs to get repaired this weekend.
Really?
I just laughed.
Yeah, I'm sure it does.
Yeah, I was like, yeah, you're going to hate doing it.
You know what's going to have to get repaired next weekend? That walkway.
Yeah. My wife for Mother's Day literally disappeared on a Thursday.
Really?
And the next time I saw her was me picking her up at a winery on a Sunday.
Nice.
So it's like, and I was like, look, you disappeared for 4 days. I'm opting to go with the family somewhere because, if you don't have the kids, you're not a father.
Right, yeah.
So
right.
I was
going to
do
sure.
the Father's Day thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I was like, but the one thing I am telling you is I'm not fixing your walkway.
Yeah.
So it's Mother's Day gets a break from the kids. Father's Day, you have to be with the kids.
I choose. I could do whatever. I didn't get a call telling me I could go away for 4 days. Otherwise, I probably would have opted for it. Let's be honest. I'm as what did Chris Rock say? You're a man's as loyal as his options.
Yeah.
Faithful as his options. Right. Well, this is me. My options said, we don't have anything going on. So I said, not doing the walkway, going tubing. And then you can drive me home from a brewery on Sunday.
There you go.
Big plans. Big plans.
Yourself, Ailey?
Oh, I'll be at the river.
Just be at the river?
Floating and boating and being awesome in general.
Nice.
Yeah.
So no different.
No.
Standard issue.
A Tuesday, essentially.
Yeah.
A Tuesday.
Big boobs coming out of you.
Yeah, so no.
I like it. Oh, it's a celebratory weekend.
I know.
No doubt
I'm
about that.
I'm excited about it.
We got Father's Day, and then tomorrow, well, Saturday is Juneteenth, and tomorrow I have Juneteenth off.
Yeah, my girlfriend's company just found
Juneteenth
out.
What is Juneteenth off? But what is Juneteenth?
So
yeah, so it's funny because Stu just gave the look, kind of like, I've heard this word.
Yeah, because my girlfriend's company just gave her for Juneteenth, they get a day off, but they can take it whenever. Because Juneteenth is a Saturday.
That's not how holidays work.
That is not how holidays work.
So the holiday's on a Saturday, per the president. And
oh, is that why? Is it always a Saturday?
It's brand new.
No, so it's not brand new.
It's as a federal holiday.
It's from the 1800s. It's so when did the Civil War end? 1896 or 46?
65.
So right in between the two? Uh-huh. Perfect. So Juneteenth would have been 2.5 years after that is when it was first recognized as Freedom Day. So to give you a little background, Juneteenth is we obviously had the Civil War for all of us American listeners. For anyone outside of that, we had a war where we fought with each other.
Pew pew.
Now we call it Thanksgiving, where brothers and brothers fight each other.
Right.
It's just, but back then we did it for many years, and it was the Civil War, and at the end of the Civil War, there was the Emancipation Proclamation, right, where we freed the slaves. And
how stupid was it that we used to walk in lines and we were like, this is the best way to fight these people.
Oh, yeah.
This is tactical warfare.
Trust us. And we were geniuses because we were like, we're just going to run through the woods. You think that'll work?
You know the crazy part about that, though, is like the first time that version of warfare showed up, it was like, it was undefeated for decades.
Yeah.
People were like, oh my gosh, there's a line of people shooting guns.
Exactly.
Yeah, there's no chivalry, or not chivalry, but there's no
sex in the champagne
loyalty.
Room.
Yeah, that's
no,
true.
Yeah,
that's it. No, you really got it.
Yeah,
that
I nailed
sex
it.
In the champagne
minus
room.
10 for Stu.
No, it was a disrespect of towards warfare if you weren't fighting the way the British.
Oh, that's right. That's a good point. It was very like honorable.
Okay. Yeah. It wasn't honorable. Yeah. That's what, I couldn't think of the word.
These guys are hiding.
Yeah.
I'm going to die standing up in front of you.
Yeah. How dare you?
Yeah. I'm going to hide.
Yeah, for
I'm
sure.
I'm going to hide.
Yeah.
And as soon as you come through the gully, I'm going to come over the ridge.
Right.
In a straight line with all of my brothers
just like
in arms.
The Ghost and the Patriot. Everybody's seen it. You know.
Dude.
Learn that from the Indians.
Patriots still. I love watching that movie. But so the Emancipation Proclamation was issued after the Civil War. The slaves were freed, but there were parts of our Union that were very far from the East Coast, essentially.
And no internet, right?
No internet, no.
So there was no way for them to know.
Well, on the East Coast, we had internet, but the West Coast was very spotty.
Yeah.
Very spotty.
It must have had T-Mobile.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And so there was a general, and the name escapes me, but he was a Union general. And he had gone down to Galveston, Texas, because.
So you're saying that
Gordon Granger.
There we go.
So the emancipation's done, but just because we're so separated and not connected, there are states that have no fucking clue that this happened, is basically what's going on.
So what happened was he went down to Galveston, Texas. He went down to Galveston June 19th, 1865, to arrive with the news that the war ended and all the enslaved slaves were now free.
Okay.
Yeah, you're kind of glossing over to Ely's question, though. The Union was so wide.
Yeah.
That where we had been fighting, it was well known.
Yeah.
The news had traveled, but so far, but where the Union didn't have a stronghold of troops, it wasn't really enforced because it was very much kind of the Wild West.
Yeah, yeah.
So in Galveston, Texas, in particular.
So parts of the Confederacy lost, and they were like, we ain't passing the word. Fuck you.
Yeah, we're not doing it because there's no Union troops here.
Yeah, to enforce anything.
Right.
So what do I care?
Right.
It's basically like if there's no cops,
yeah,
then there's no speeding.
Right, right.
So, yeah, you can say that they're speeding.
I'm not picking that cotton myself, motherfucker.
Yeah, so there was, unfortunately,
yeah,
that was still happening in Texas, right?
Mm-hmm.
So 2.5 years went by. 2.5 years.
Dude, that's crazy.
And that's
they needed the internet.
Yeah, so this general comes down because he's heard that his troops don't have any say.
Yeah.
You know, it's kind of running amok. So this dude goes out there on June 19th, 2.5 years after the Emancipation Proclamation was signed. And he stands up, and he's got his troops with him, and he's like, this is bullshit. You all are free. And he got up, and he made the big speech and the announcement, and then that news obviously spread, but now they had the support of the military was there backing him.
Yeah, that's
so
awesome.
This is when they actually were freed in a lot of black people's minds. The Emancipation Proclamation is not when we were free. It was the thought. It was when the last of us were finally freed. That we were free, and
that's pretty cool.
And that's what June 19th, or now Juneteenth, were back then, Freedom Day. And so what happened is a celebration broke out.
Okay.
And they celebrated, and that became the celebration, the first Freedom
Day. So since this happened, it's been getting celebrated in some pockets.
Exactly.
Really?
Yes. Yeah. So the next year, on June 19th, the families that were there that it immediately impacted celebrated the anniversary.
Right.
And then it kept going, and it became Juneteenth, and it has spread.
That's
so
crazy.
So that is what Juneteenth is.
Do you know people that have celebrated Juneteenth prior to now?
So I had only heard Juneteenth years ago on a TV show. I saw someone mention it.
Really?
And I
heard
like,
the word, but I didn't know what they were talking about.
I unfortunately was ignorant to it.
I wonder how prevalent it was or is.
My guess. Is that in Texas and places that were closer to it,
yeah,
it was a bigger deal and probably is more prominent.
Yeah, that makes sense.
And then when you get to somewhere like where we are, you know, on the East Coast, it probably just wasn't celebrated as much.
Right.
But I'm sure it was in the vernacular, right? Like people spoke it. We just didn't.
It may be, but to your point, the area closest to where the Civil War ended, you know, Virginia and spreading out, where word traveled relatively quickly, it just that okay we're free.
We assumed everyone knew.
Everybody's good. Yeah. We don't have to celebrate it. It's not really as prevalent. But then the places like you're saying, it takes forever to get to. Well,
I can see.
Hey, we're two out. We're two.
So
there's
a chance that no one up in this area ever celebrated it.
I'm sure somebody did, but yeah, sure.
Well, until it was brought here, the idea or something. Yeah. If it was truly that everyone
oh man that first
knew.
Year yeah 100% it was just a do you consider Texas the West Coast? Is that the...
No, I mean, then you do, but now you don't.
Is that the Midwest? What is... Texas
That's
is...
That's Southwest. We'll go Southwest.
Okay, so at that I time bet they you were it was more popular to, in the Southwest.
Yeah.
At that time, they're still
Serious
trying to...
Serious tacos, so yeah. Southwest, right?
Definitely.
Yes.
That's a good thing. If tacos are prevalent...
Yeah, overly
not just,
prevalent.
Not just with a bell attached to it, but
yeah.
like prevalent.
I mean, it's...
That's an area that probably knew more about Juneteenth.
If it's Southwest, but they were still trying to figure out how they were separating themselves from Mexico after becoming a state.
Yeah, Texas says it's hell. Texas is still trying to figure out how to separate themselves from us today.
Don't assume its identity.
So Texas or Juneteenth though just got recognized as a federal holiday. Well, I guess
really?
we're one Biden vote away.
Okay.
It has passed through everything else
right.
to this point. So it is now next year will officially be a federal holiday.
He said he signed the bill.
Okay.
So he did sign it.
Yeah.
So is
That's why.
So is tomorrow a federal holiday for, or well, today when this episode comes out?
I don't know. They're not, let's see here.
So my company gives it off.
Really?
We had it off last year, had it off this year.
Interesting.
Because we were purchased a few years ago by a pretty progressive company. And so we get Juneteenth, which is great. And they really encourage us. They're like, reflect on what this is.
Yeah.
You know, they try to encourage that. So we have the day off, but now that it's become a federal holiday, I question if this is, and I'm glad you're here, Ely, because this is...
Hey, man, glad to be here.
Yeah, thank you. Because
I have tons of Juneteenth insight.
You may not.
Not at all.
But we have talked about many times before how holidays over time, when we're given them, they become more commercial or they become thought of less. And in my mind, here's kind of how I was thinking about this. Like, Memorial Day is a somber day.
Yeah.
But it is not in this country. We cook burgers. We get the day off. We drink beer. We hang out. We do fly flags. I'll give it that.
Right.
But it's a day to remember the fallen. And I would think that Memorial Day originally was probably about going to a loved one's grave, or we're getting together with family and thinking about them. And then I can see how over time it has shifted, because we've gotten further and further from the truth of it. So do you think there's any possibility that now that it's recognized and it's getting bigger, that it'll lose some of its specialness to the group that it was, you know, more sacred to originally, and kind of, or is,
I think you have a few decades before that happens. I mean, I think bringing attention to something like this is what this will do. In other words, we're talking about it right now.
Yes.
More people are going to know what it is.
And it's going to be, I was going to say, it's going to be more prevalent in Texas, New York, Virginia, and Washington, because they're the only four states that currently will do it as a paid holiday.
I thought you said it was a federal holiday.
For state employees.
Yeah. We last year declared it.
Yeah.
A state holiday.
Oh, okay.
So that happened last year in Virginia, but now it's federal. All federal gets off. And I just always, as soon as I heard that, I was excited and I was happy and I thought that's a great thing. And we should celebrate this. I'm happy about that. But then I was like, is this the genesis of, like, this is its peak? And then it's like it slowly gets commercialized and we have Juneteenth cards and different things. And does it lose its meaning?
But is Juneteenth cards bad?
That's what I don't know if it is, because it's like,
it brings more notoriety to an issue, right? Imagine how many people would be celebrating dead soldiers if you didn't have Memorial Day. It'd be way less than it is now.
Far less. Yeah, right. Okay, that's a fair point.
It would just it brings more notoriety and recognition to this issue, and that this is something that we did and that we dealt with. So I don't see any way in which that can't be a good thing. Now, however, in 20 years, 30 years, 40 years, sure, it could get watered down and we're going and doing some crazy shit where we're shopping or doing
That's
something.
What I would hate to see, right? Like, oh, man, you want that washer and dryer. Let's wait till Juneteenth. Well, that's what I don't want
to see. That's going to
see.
Happen.
So you think
but
that
I don't know. Is that bad? I get back to that point. Is that bad?
But we have talked in the past about how holidays have gotten ruined by getting overly commercial.
I totally agree, but is, you know.
But overly commercial, I mean, so you have the day off. Why wouldn't any business, regardless, market to you and say, hey, you got some time to come shop?
Because yeah, like, that's when capitalism starts to creep
that's
in.
That's my point. Is it bad that you got a deal on something?
No.
And it's at the regardless same time bringing recognition to something else.
Does it marginalize?
Like, what do you want people to do? Cry in a corner for 4 hours? How many minutes of crying is sufficient for you?
Actually, it's not about crying. I agree. It's a celebration because it's Freedom Day.
But it's a point that I'm bringing up. Like, how much time of reflection is sufficient for Brendan?
Ah, now there's an interesting question. 75 years. I want to be dead and gone.
Put it in the books.
I want to be dead and gone before the first washer and dryer goes on sale.
Exactly.
On Juneteenth.
So is there anything wrong with me being like, I wake up Juneteenth and I'm like, oh, Nomine Patri, Spiritus Sancti. Today was, in remembrance of, thank God for those that came before us. Cool. Where's my fucking new refrigerator? Is there anything wrong with that?
I guess not. I guess the reason this
thought. Or I need to say that more, or like. You know
yeah,
what I mean?
I want at least 10 Hail Marys.
That's kind of. Right. Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah, because I guess in my mind there was a segment of the population that this meant more to, and that's why I see
that argument, but I don't see the argument that those people wouldn't want more people to know about it.
Okay, no, I'm sorry. I think I'm following you now. So they're not losing anything.
No,
but they're gaining that everyone else now understands.
Yeah,
and as that. So in through that lens, it's absolutely. I mean, because I'm not looking at this. I think everyone should have the holiday. I get that.
Yeah, yeah.
It's just, I was trying to wrap my head around. Does it water it down? But no, it actually makes it stronger.
No, I think what waters it, when time is what waters it down. Because I'm not worried about the PR marketing or whatever for any holiday, whether you're getting a deal or not. But like, if you look at Memorial Day, you'll see people on social media all the time who are like, oh yeah, my dad, thanks for serving, or my brother, thanks for serving. They're not dead. They're sitting right next to you. That's not the Memorial is for.
Yeah, that's frustrating. Veterans Day, I call my dad. I usually text Ely. Like, I just, Stu, I'll start hitting you up. My bad.
That's okay.
No, I'm sure I've texted you as well. Like on Veterans Day, I reach out, but I don't have anyone to reach out to on Memorial Day because it's a moment of reflection for me.
And I don't have anybody, I guess. I mean, who would you reach out to on a Juneteenth holiday or any other holiday that's kind of like?
I guess that's true. It's just 1800s.
It's just history. You want to maintain a noted date.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it doesn't water it down at all. It actually makes it much stronger.
Yeah.
Because now we all are aware of it.
Yes.
And
absolutely.
Now there's dozens of more people who didn't understand the history who now understand it from us.
The reality of it is everybody understands the Emancipation Proclamation. Or hopefully has a grasp of that idea.
Yes.
But what they don't know is that due to the fact that we can't instantly in 1 second light up the entire world with information like we do now, it took 2.5 years for to get to Galveston from Appomattox when the Civil War was over.
That's precisely it. Yeah. And so for 2.5 years,
there was still an
issue. Free people were still enslaved. And that's just the extra kick in the ass of that whole moment in time.
It's like when Planet Fitness told me they didn't cancel my membership, and for 2.5 years I was paying it.
It's actually not like that at all. I like that, Stu.
Well, how much is Martin Luther King Day? How much does that contribute to our children knowing about him and the great things that he did?
A ton.
Absolutely, that's the answer right there. Right.
Because you know, as it comes up on the horizon, kids are taught about Martin Luther King comes up. Yeah, so that's a great thing.
But then your original idea sucked. What's next?
I didn't have an original. I was wondering.
No,
if
I know. I enjoy the conversation. I got to also be funny by making fun of you. You know.
Yeah.
That.
Well, I understand how it works.
Right. I know you do.
Yeah. I was. I think my point was mistaken a little bit. No, I am in agreement with all of this. I'm just trying to wrap my head around. At what point does it water down? But I've come around. It doesn't. It doesn't water it down at all.
Yeah, I don't think it does.
It just gets stronger. It's time that messes things up.
As long as you maintain the true meaning and definition of what the day is celebrating and avoid what time can do. Because we're 77 years removed from World War II. You know, the guys that actually fought, they're in their late 90s. There's a handful of them. So you got to remember.
Yeah.
You know,
but I go back to my earlier point. I agree that over time it waters down, but it's still... But it's better
to have it.
Yeah. It's better than not.
I mean, I guess so. I mean, if in 200 years there's still.
I think the number of people that think that Memorial Day is only for barbecuing is fucking minuscule.
I hope
they end up only barbecuing. That's what they do. But deep back in places in their stomach where they don't talk about it in their head, they know what's going on.
I hope so.
Yeah.
So then this is awesome on every level.
For sure.
See? Look
what's next?
I worked through some stuff. Yeah, that was it. I just had celebrations. I was Father's Day and Juneteenth. That's what I was wrapping my head around. But it makes for an interesting weekend. So Father's Day will often fall right around that time.
Yeah.
This is going to be a good weekend for dads.
Absolutely.
Look, especially dads who have federal jobs and state jobs.
Yeah, yeah.
Because some companies don't, you know, they don't always do the federal holidays.
Yeah. No.
So I'm glad my company does.
Yeah, good for you.
Very cool. Very cool. Hey, I got a deli for you in there that I'm going to, well, I have two delis. If you look in there, one of them is a lemon hefeweizen.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Which I figure you might like, but it's got notes of lemon, which you may miss.
And the other one is a...
The other one's a standard issue beer, but I figure you'd want to try the lemon hefeweizen, right?
You thought correctly.
All right. So this is
Great Lakes Brewing, huh?
Yes.
Good old
lemon hefeweizen.
Hefeweizen.
Yeah, whatever.
Hefeweizen.
The hefe.
Did you already have one?
No. This was just seltzer.
I got you.
No, we've been keeping it.
You drinking a holy? Yeah, you are. Absolutely. I'm only drinking a partial, so you want to put some in there? Or?
Yeah. All right. Yeah, there you go. Yeah, I'm excited to try this. I'm nervous that it's going to be over lemony. Does that make sense?
So, let's see here. Great Lakes Brewing Company, Lemon Hefeweizen, Ale with Lemon. Squeeze into your snazziest swimwear and float away with this frothy, zesty, cooler companion brewed with enough lemon puree to last a long weekend.
Can you smell it?
That's exactly what Brendan doesn't want to hear. Enough lemon puree.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
So 5.1. Let's see if this thing kicks it.
See how this goes here. Well, Lily's first taste was that if you'd farted in his mouth.
Yeah, for sure. Which I may have preferred.
Not good.
This is interesting.
Are my taste buds off, or does this taste like shit? And am I being set up in that you knew it tasted like shit?
No.
And this is good pod?
This is an honest to goodness.
Okay.
This is an honest to goodness.
Because I feel like I'm being punked.
Happy Father's Day, Ely. We just got you.
Yeah. Literally.
Oh, this has been skunked for 4 days.
Right. We soaked this in our butts for a week.
I've had this in my trunk for 6 years.
Exactly. Yeah, that's what
it's
I'm
lemony.
Getting. Those are the notes that I'm getting.
Yeah. Trunk and butt.
Born on date 1865. No.
There's some weird aftertaste.
I think it's the...
Well...
You're right. It's almost like either salt water or chlorinated water or something.
Something like that.
Which, look at you picking up on notes.
I mean, who doesn't think that chlorine's good for beer? Yeah. I mean, most people, right?
Oh, my gosh. I just bought this stuff. It's like... For my dentures, my stupid Invisalign, it's like they had this stuff, and it was called like minty fresh. You know, you could like soak them in there, and it'll like clean them off. And I was like, all right, cool. I got this cleaning solution because I wake up with bad breath with these things in.
Yeah.
So I was like, maybe I just need to clean them more. So I soaked these thing in there, and then I rinsed them off, and I put them in. And it tastes like somebody just completely over-chlorinated the pool, and it just ruins your whole mouth. It wasn't minty fresh at all. Got lied to, but I'm picking up on
that
a little of that.
Is one of the worst beers I've tried in a long time.
That bad.
And I'm trying to think if it's worse than IPAs. Like, I don't know. It's that bad.
It is not that bad. It's not good.
It's horrible. Yeah, it's not as bad as an IPA. Can I just give my score?
Oh, I think we're starting with you.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, that shit sucks.
The question is, does Ely like it?
No. He does not.
Does
not. I'm going to say it's getting a 2, folks.
My 2.
Yeah. If I debated less, but then we're getting into like DKML territory.
Ugh.
And that shit, might as well pour it in a shoe.
That'd be horrible for your shoe.
Yeah. 2. I feel comfortable with my 2.
Yeah. Okay.
One sip. Everybody knows the rules.
That's right.
There you go.
Have you ever known? He always says, one bite, everyone knows the rules, and then he takes 5 bites.
And he says it to the guest, too, and the guest always thinks it's the real rule.
Yeah.
So the guest takes 1 and is like, 7, and he's eating the whole goddamn thing.
He goes, let me try it from the bottom.
He said one bite.
One bite, everybody knows the rules. Yeah. 7 bites later and 3 minutes of just pontificating.
Right.
Shit. Well, I'll tell you this much. I'll give it a little bit for the try on the can, going for the whole yellow lemon, like Great Lakes on the beachfront. But as far as a Hefeweizen go, I don't know. Oh, what do you guys
like? Yeah, I don't think it's a Hefeweizen.
No, it's struggling.
It's got a little Hefeweizen.
Does it?
Yeah.
I don't know.
It's got a little of that pepperiness, none of that but banana.
Yeah.
That back end taste that you can't put your finger on, like that's what I think it's the can.
It like, could be. That see that back end taste tastes like metal to me. Like,
yeah, it's very like, very canny.
I'm going old school PBR. Like I taste the it could be the can. So maybe he did leave it in his trunk for 4 years. I don't
possibly.
Know. But I don't know if I'd be searching this out. Marketing's decent, but yeah.
You've got 3 more to drink. So.
2.5.
These are the worst when these show up, these delis, cuz they don't go well and then I know I don't like them. And then they just sit there. There was a period at the beginning of the pandemic.
Do you find yourself lying to people that come in and you're like, dude, this lemon heffy, give it a run?
I mean, I've had people pick them up and go, ooh, what's that? I'm like, you might like it.
Yeah, you
like,
do.
I'll say that.
Just so you don't lie.
Yes, I won't lie to them.
Right.
I won't.
You may love it.
Yeah, you may think that's great. You may not.
Don't ask me.
It could also be the water from the lake that they use.
It's Lake Erie.
Shit Lake?
Yeah.
It's the grossest.
Chicago.
It's the grossest of the Great Lakes. That's for sure.
Yeah, I mean, it's a 2.5 because I'm kind of, the artwork's kind of cool. Can is interesting, but it doesn't have anything.
Yeah, I don't find anything repulsive about it. There is an aftertaste that you guys are absolutely right. It's not good. It's too lemony.
Yeah.
Somehow dries out the back of my mouth, which I don't understand for a refreshing beer. I feel like they're almost going for kind of that over the top. If somebody likes seltzers,
well, no, it's almost,
maybe they'll like
they're
this.
Missing one thing to make it a shandy.
Yeah,
like it's almost
there,
but not.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. I'm gonna go right down the middle because it's not disagreeable. It's not agreeable. I'll never buy it again. It's a 2.5. So a 2.5.
Cool.
Well done, Great Lakes. They
four
are
and a half.
They are not. they're not doing well.
Six pack cost.
I wouldn't know because I bought it at the Lucky, so everything's overpriced.
So
$11.50.
It's not worth $9.
Yeah, I love how you quickly did the math. That's exactly right. So that's a $9 six pack. That's a bummer. A little disappointed in that one.
For sure. I saw you got some Molson down there. Good call.
That was the other option for the other deli.
Oh, really?
Yeah, because we've never done standard Molson Canadian.
Yeah.
I saw
jealous. That
and I was like, ooh, I love Molson Canadian.
Yeah, at least I think I do.
Well, that was the other side of it. Like, I remember having Molson when I was, like, younger.
Yeah.
But I can't remember the last time I tasted one.
Ely is here. We have plenty of it.
True. I could just give it my score and then you could do it later.
Or we could take one and split it.
If you choose to crack a Molson and just give your score, we can back it up later.
You're not going to not taste the Molson I open.
Yeah, that's
would
right.
You not?
Well, we have another podcast after this. I may need it.
Okay.
I don't need it. But it is going to be a bourbon
I'm
taste.
I'm super satisfied with this lemon beer that I just drank.
No, you're not. Yeah. No, you're not.
No, based on the next podcast, our taste buds would be fried. Look at that, the lemon.
It's not good.
No.
It's not good. It's almost like a Leinenkugel, and I hate Leinenkugel.
But their lemon shandy's not for, but it's a shandy. It's not even in the same ballpark.
That's why when you said shandy, I was like, he's absolutely right. This is better than an experience I had this week, which is positive. I'll give it that.
Did you hear him say I was absolutely right? Can I
get
10 points
I
back?
I did.
Thank you.
Five.
Okay. Five. I was going to say the exact same thing.
Yeah.
This dude's still at -5.
Right.
Like 500.
Yeah, but you
attempted to take away points, though, for asking for points. Who does that?
I don't know why he does that.
Right. Because I need.
You got to dig out of the hole. I
get it.
You're
totally
embarrassing yourself.
I don't care.
What do I have to lose? Points? Fair enough.
You guys are feeding me this shit beer. I got nothing better to do.
Dude, there was a few weeks ago, I was taking my daughter somewhere, and she says, Dad, there's mouse poop in my car seat, in my cup holder.
Yeah.
And I'm like, there's no mouse poop in your cup holder. Like, you're such a slob back there. Because her side of the car, it's a nightmare. There's like,
is there one side that's clean and one that's not?
I mean, one side that's clean for a kid.
Okay.
And one side that's dirty for a slovenly kid.
Really?
Like, it's even dirtier.
Oh, so one of them's clearly dirtier than the other?
Oh, yeah.
Really?
Yeah, my younger one is me. Total slob. Total
nice.
Slob. The older one is my wife.
Gotcha.
Just anal. Like, things need to be in their place.
Right.
Keep it clean. And so, yeah, when you get back there, it's a tale of two cities in the car.
Yeah.
Except for in my wife's car, because she constantly cleans it out and keeps it, you know, up nice.
Yeah.
I will just allow the slob to be the slob. So she literally sits there with her feet up, elevated, like, so her knees are up near her face. Because she just stacks her crap, and I'm like, yep, that's your crap. You better get it. She's like,
it doesn't know you to death?
I don't sit back there.
I could.
But your car's nasty.
I get the problem.
Oh, okay.
But I'm a slob.
Okay.
Like, left to my own devices, boy, it's not a good scene.
Yeah.
And so she's got that one side of the car just wrecked. And so she's like, hey, there's mouse poop in my cup holder. And I'm like, clearly there's not mouse poop in your cup holder. Right. Why would a mouse be in the car?
Yeah.
So I go back there and I look in and I'm like, oh my God, that looks a little bit like mouse poop. Like,
please tell me there's mice in your car because of all her shit.
Yeah, so I'm like, there's a little, does kind of look like mouse poop. But we never saw a mouse, and I figured it must have been a one-time thing. Like a storm rolls through, mouse comes in, shelter from the storm, craps in the cup holder and bounces.
Yeah.
So then I guess it was probably like 6 weeks goes
super
by.
Super common.
Six weeks goes by, and all I did to address the mouse problem was vacuum out her cup holder one time. Burm! Left all of her crap down there.
There's, oh, so you got the vacuum out, but you didn't pull the trash can and get the shit on the floor.
I got some of it out, but I left, like, I was
really?
Like...
What? Let's dig through the psychology
okay,
of this.
Okay,
why are you leaving some?
Because...
You're already there.
I have the same mentality that she does. So I was like, oh, well, that's a sweatshirt. It's good to have a sweatshirt in the car.
She may need that at some point.
Yes.
Right.
So I have the same miswired brain. So there were certain things I saw back there that I thought.
But nothing nasty.
No, no. If I found like a old milk, I got rid of that. If I found food, I got rid of that.
But after you ate the leftovers.
I was like, that fry's still good.
For sure.
How long does chocolate milk last? Probably longer than that.
Yeah, it's been kind of chilly outside.
Yeah, it's only been there since October.
Yeah.
So I got rid of all that kind of crap. But yeah, I left like, okay, I see the value in an umbrella. I see the value in a sweatshirt. A second sweatshirt. Sure, I could see that her sister might get cold. Like, this is how I rationalize
I got
these
you.
Things. I don't know.
Meanwhile,
you go through my cup holder,
meanwhile you're just building your case.
Yeah, see, like, I'm with you now. I was thinking, like, Hot Pocket wrappers and shit like that.
No, all the trash was removed. Okay. All the food was removed. But some of her just crap.
Yeah.
I'm like, oh, a book? Well, she might need a book.
Yeah.
Go on a road trip. I don't know. So I get in the car just this past week, and it's been weeks since we first vacuumed out the mouse poop.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm driving to get my haircut. And I've had, you ever have one of those days where, like, I mean, literally everything is just going wrong?
Oh, absolutely.
I woke up, first thing I woke up to was an email from a client with the damn red exclamation mark. And it was like, I need this by this. And it's like, oh, the hell. I'm pretty sure you already have that, but that's a slight enough twist. Yeah. And now we got to redo the whole damn thing.
Right.
Right behind it. Boom. Email from my boss. Exclamation mark. Why haven't, what's wrong? You screwed this up.
Yeah.
And I'm like, oh, that's two daggers to start my day.
Right.
So now I'm like defending myself, multiple people. And it just seems like that flood just kept coming all day. And I was like, this sucks. Finally, I'm like, all right, I got to go get this haircut. I run out, got an appointment, haul ass out, get in my car, pull down the road.
Please tell me this is going where I think it's going.
It's not going as far as you think it's going. It doesn't get the climax you want.
Like, he doesn't get into your hat and start making food
exactly,
and stuff?
No,
okay,
no.
Like a chef?
Like, I'm just, yeah. I got, so I'm Ratatouille now.
There are
long story short, I made some amazing muffins.
Exactly. Yeah. All right, next topic.
No, there's no M&Ms getting into the heater.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, so then, but my damn air conditioner, when I turn it on, goes tick, 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 tick. And I'm like, why is it ticking?
Yeah.
Like, what the hell is this? It's like I'm hitting the buttons, and I find that if I use fresh air, the tick goes away. Yeah. But if I recycle, it keeps ticking.
I love how we feel like turn it off and hit the button harder, and that's
like, might work.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah. The mechanical
flaw.
It's
the flaw. Nintendo trick.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There we go. That should work.
Uh-huh.
So then I'm like playing with the buttons, and I'm driving, and then all of a sudden I just feel like stuff go down my leg. Like, and I'm like,
what does that mean?
It just, I didn't know at the time. I thought it was water.
Okay.
I thought water had like somehow dripped. So now I'm thinking the air conditioner's completely honked.
Yeah.
Because it's ticking, and now water's dumping out of my dash. It was not water dumping out of my dash. It was like someone had popped the balloon of mouse turds that was hanging beneath there, and mouse turds were falling down my leg. What? Yeah.
From the console?
Yeah, all of a sudden.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, it's just like a shower of mouse turds breaks loose.
What vehicle
somewhere.
Is this?
My nicest one.
Yeah.
My
this
newest,
is
the
Infinity.
My daily driver. I understand that if your 1985 shitbox is full of mice. No, no, no. This is like, this
don't
is
you have
nice.
Electric gremlins in that thing, too?
Yes.
Yeah, you do.
I've had to replace the dash.
Yep.
Because out of nowhere, it just fried one day. Like,
yeah. That's the exact same thing I said when he told me.
It's exactly
it.
What he said. He goes, you've had a lot of electrical problems in there. And I'm like, and it's all coming together. Like,
yes.
I have spent so much money on electrical gremlins in that car. And it's because there's a family of freaking mice.
Yep.
Just, hey, we need some more bedding. Yeah, get the red wire.
Right.
Yeah.
Damn it.
Thousands of dollars to the dealer, and all I needed was a 99 cent.
I didn't even
trap.
Notice this. Like it's so the turds are running down my legs. And I'm like, what the hell? And I'm driving, and then like I scratch my leg and there's like mouse turds in my hand that were in my hairs and everything. And I'm like, oh my gosh. And I kind of panicked a little as I was driving. Then it occurred to me, I'm such a man that if a mouse had fallen out onto my leg, I probably would have died.
Really?
Because I swerved so much over a turd.
Yeah.
You know? Like, if mouse turds can make me swerve a little, a real mouse catching me off guard probably would have put me in a bridge abutment.
Yeah,
you know? Like, that would have been bad. So then I'm like, what the hell? There's turds everywhere. And I pull over, and I look at my dash, and I'd been so, like, consumed with my bad day, and I was late. There's puddles of pee on my dash.
What?
And mouse turds all across it. Like he had just had a field day and just evacuated his bowels all over my dash.
What?
I'm not kidding.
So, guys, if you're listening.
Is he still living in the car?
No.
So what'd you do?
I went and got one of those. I have humane traps in the house.
Oh, cool.
And so I put this thing in there because my kids don't want a dead mouse. It's like. Dude, I mean, immediately I put this thing in there because I first cleaned the car.
Wait a minute, hold on. Let's back up to the humane thing. What does it mean by humane? Like they die in their sleep?
Yeah, it this podcast just plays.
Yeah,
and they just slowly die.
Right.
No, it's like a tube, and then on one end it's got like a flap, and you can open that up and you put food on the flap. And then you push down a flap on the other side, and when it walks in and goes to get the food and it lands on the little trap door, then the other end flips up, and now it is trapped inside of this little container with air holes.
Then what do you do with it?
Is it a catch-and-release program, or you just let them starve to death?
I have let them starve to death on accident. I have forgotten I've said this.
What are you
supposed
to do? Like, what are you trying to do with it?
You just take it somewhere else and release it.
That's
so
the humane
part.
So it
fucks somebody else's shit up?
Yeah.
Cool.
So, like, I took it. I found
to
a
your
nice
neighbor's Hyundai?
Yeah, exactly. Here's a nice car.
My neighbor's S got an Escalade.
But what I was going to say is, if anybody's listening, Brendan's got an Infiniti for sale.
Right. Yeah.
A couple electrical gremlins. Yeah.
Don't talk me down. I know what I got.
Final pricing.
That is my favorite line.
Mine
like,
too.
Don't talk me down. I know what I've got.
Yeah.
Yeah, unfortunately. Yeah, I know what I've got. I've got electrical wires half chewed through all over this car.
So you've set out more traps and nothing's.
I have.
You're convinced you got the one.
I think it was just the one that's been living in there for quite some time, eating off of old fries and chewing up. Like I went through in the back.
Yeah.
I pulled out, like, I have a dog blanket back there.
Yep.
And I pulled that out, and it had little holes in it where he had, like, chewed through to make beds. And I pulled that out and just turds started falling.
Yeah.
There were turds in every corner of this car, and not just, like, a couple turds.
Yeah.
I was driving around in a literal shit box.
That's crazy. Like,
for years.
Yeah, you were a rodent shit box. Yeah.
Will this car go any faster? What, you got hamster wheels in the engine?
Yeah.
Well, actually.
Yeah. Funny you say that, Stu.
Just mice. Just mice. Yeah, it's an actual shit box.
Yeah. Hamsters. This is an Infiniti. We have mice.
Yeah.
Humane mice.
I tell you, one of the most gorgeous mice I'd ever seen.
Really?
Yeah, when I got it out. Like
Lemmy Winks?
Very much so.
Yeah.
Yes, very, very Lemmy Winks. Yeah, I kept it.
Yeah, you did. In a tube.
Yes, exactly.
Did you? Right. Where did you release it?
That's the point.
Yeah. Still with me, Stu.
tickle.
Yeah.
I geared it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Way to go, Richard.
That kills me.
No, I just took it down to the end of the cul-de-sac and went to the other side and let him go, and he just took off running, found himself a Porsche.
Yeah,
he did.
Right over there.
See, not me. I got the ones. I'd be sitting in my living room at night and watching TV, and I hear whoosh. I'm like, ooh, got one.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. So you get to really kill him.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
The eyeballs all pop out. And they're like.
Yeah. I'm not allowed to kill him in this house. Yeah. It's all humane here.
Yeah, it is.
The girls can't stand that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
We caught one night. Well, I wouldn't even say we caught it. Like, we went out in the garage, and this thing just kept spinning in circles. Like, something was obviously wrong with it. It was at the end of its life. My daughter caught me out there about to destroy it. And she was like, I'm like, it's suffering. And, like, you could see that something had gutted it.
Yeah.
Like, it had just gotten away from whatever had attacked it. It's got its guts hanging out. It's in the house. I'm trying to put it out of its misery, and she won't let me.
I think... Why do you... There's a case could be made for you needing to have her see that. Like, why are you folding to what the kid wants? That's not right.
Because I was mildly conflicted about stomping on it, too. Like, the thought of doing it.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, I was like, ugh, I got to kill this mouse now.
Right. Yeah. But could you just...
I'm just saying in general.
Can you go back inside, sweetie, and then just take the shovel to the mouse and be done with it?
Yeah.
Oh, I mean, she caught me about to just drop something. It was almost like if I put my foot on it, then I killed it. If I dropped a phone book from here, then the phone book killed it.
It's not me. It's gravity.
Right.
I don't understand why that logic kind of works in my head.
No, it works. It makes sense. I can dig it.
But it kind of, I was like, no, honey, I'm not gonna stomp it. Mm. I'll just drop this on it. And she was like, ah! And I was like,
it's
okay.
Just the way you, like, they don't like that. Like, that phrase to me, like, a lot of people don't like things, but they need to encounter things in their life to make them better, right?
Yeah, maybe I should have done it. Then I could have gotten over my, you know, like.
And I'm not saying that specific issue. I was just thinking in general. And the whole, like, just saying that my kid doesn't like that. I mean, I don't know. I'm just wandering in my head.
No, but I mean, I know what you're saying. Like, the first time, like, if a kid actually gets to go, like, hunt.
Yeah.
And then it's like they feel the sadness of killing something, but then they see the joy of eating it.
Yeah.
Then it's like, okay, like, now I kind of.
Well, not just that, but even feeling that sadness is good. Instead of if you go through life where you're like, I say I don't want something, and all of a sudden I don't ever get it, it never happens, that's, like, not a good way to be. You know what I mean?
Yeah, which you have no to experience some lows.
Yes. Yeah. Yes. Yeah. That's all I was thinking.
Yeah, I didn't. I decided not to make this a teaching moment.
Yeah.
When the mouse had its guts exposed.
Yeah, good call.
And then so I took this poor bastard out. It was freezing cold in the middle of the night. And I just walked it over and, like, I tried to, like, put it down hard enough that hopefully I took it out of its misery, but at the same time, I might have just been like, this is the worst day ever. Yeah.
So I've told this story, I don't know, probably several times on this podcast about my granny catching squirrels. Did I tell you that one?
Did you literally drown them? Is that right?
Yeah.
Sorry.
You broke down the fourth wall. But yes, our whole lives, she's been doing that where she had the same type of trap where it would close down and it would just, like, fold on the sides. And she would take them to the local park. Then when she's like 90, we're at Thanksgiving dinner, and we were like, remember, Granny, you used to trap them squirrels and take them to the park? She's like, the park? I was drowning them bastards in the creek the whole time. And we're like, oh, my God.
So she did it for show. The humane trap was
absolutely
for show.
Absolutely, yes.
Yeah.
Or was she sadistic?
No,
because
it was for show.
If you hear the snap, snap!
Yeah.
Then, like, it's over. But she's like, nope, now I got it.
Yeah.
Well, my grandparents and my dad did the same thing probably up until I was maybe 8 years old. I had three dogs at one point in time that had to be put down. But they didn't say...
All at the same time?
No, just over. Like, I had an older dog. Yeah, that would have been interesting.
Yeah.
Had an older dog, then got one that was a little mangy.
Not carrying their load around here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And my dad just said, well, this is not working out, or this we can't have this dog anymore or whatnot. And he said, I'm taking it out to the farm. We're going to give it to the farm. They'll take care of it.
Yeah.
There's no farm.
Right. Ever. But yeah.
Hey guys, did I miss anything?
Not really.
You've been super quiet.
You missed
quiet.
An amazing beer.
Yeah, well, I just told him to get one.
You've been super quiet.
Oh, yeah.
You have been really quiet this
Everything
episode.
All right, man?
Y'all were doing so great, I just didn't want to step on
yeah.
you.
Yeah, thank you.
I get it, man.
Right.
I get it.
I'm excited to try this beer, so it sounds like y'all have already delied it, and it's crushed.
For sure.
I mean.
It's crushable.
Like a five, four,
crushable.
No, three.
I can tell you, it
Give it a whiff.
It won an award.
Lemony and bright.
Yeah.
It'll be fun to see kind of just where he lands all on his own. You know?
That's like, interesting for sure.
Yeah.
Give it a second or a third sip. See where it comes out.
We'll just see where that comes out in the wash.
Oh. Huh. It tastes like a shandy.
Yeah.
Bingo.
Yeah.
Not quite.
It certainly does.
With metal shavings.
Yeah.
Exactly.
The old metallic shandy.
Yeah.
What's your aftertaste, Troy?
Yeah, I've had two sips. I can definitely pick up on what you guys are talking about.
It's an interesting interesting beverage.
It tastes good initially.
It does. It's very shandy-ish.
Yeah.
We were just talking about mouse turds.
Nice. Oh, yeah. I wish I'd heard
Mr.
that
Jangles.
Story.
There ain't no mouseville.
Mr. Jangle. Yeah. You know, that was written by Stephen King, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That dude writes all the good stuff.
It was one of his short stories.
Yeah.
That movie was like 4 hours long.
Yeah, how the hell?
Because that's why it was such a good... They were able to take the whole book and turn it into a movie, because most books you can't condense to 3 hours.
Yeah.
So Green Mile came out really well.
All right, so I got a crazy story, and I need an opinion. Unless you're trying to wrap this shit up.
Not now.
Okay.
I am wide open now.
Right. So everyone knows that I live in the middle of the woods, right? I live on 17 acres.
Next to the prospector.
Next to the prospector. He's cool, you know. So one day, maybe 2 months ago, we're hanging out at the house. Angela and Jacob's on his way home from school. And I'm building like a desk for Angela's new office or whatever, something like that. But this fucking dude walks out of the woods, is wandering around the property.
Whoa.
Comes up to the door.
Didn't come down the driveway. Literally just
didn't come up to the driveway. Come to find out later.
You have like
Jacob,
a half mile driveway.
Right. Jacob happened to be walking down the driveway, getting off the school bus, as this dude pops out of the woods. And Jacob freaks out and goes like lays into a gully to try to hide from the guy. Yes. So the dude comes and walks in, is wandering around the house and looks disoriented and shit. Comes to the door and starts
talking to
Angela about nonsense. He looks like he's 25 to 30, beard, slightly disheveled, and he's just talking nonsense.
You have a firing range at your
right.
house.
Yes.
Yeah.
And I should say, like, not legit, but he's mercenary, military trained. And
oh, Lord.
Why do you volunteer this information? Hi.
Yeah.
I'm a mercenary.
No, he was,
came out of
the
woods.
First thing he asked was, did you get the letter in the mailbox? And Angela's like, what letter? And he's like, I don't know. I never got the letter. Just mentioned the goddamn letter.
Is this at your front door?
At our front door at like, what did Jacob get? 4 p.m. And I'm like in the twilight zone.
This guy needs to meet your bus stop guy.
Yeah, so, I would love to put them in a room.
Could be the same guy.
So they talk for like 3-4 minutes, and he ends up leaving our house, walking the opposite direction, standing in a circle, spinning around, looking at the sky, going back the other direction, then goes back and disappears through the woods. And
whoa.
I'm like, that's fucking weird. What the fuck? So then, this morning, 7 a.m., I'm in my undies with the wife, drinking coffee. This motherfucker comes out the woods to our back door.
No shit.
The back door of my home, rapping on the glass window of the glass door, not window, of our patio.
Can see you like sitting
there. I don't
know
if you can see me or not, but he walked up and he's like,
what?
So I'm like,
hell?
What the fuck?
And this
man?
Is the reason you, this is, these are the reasons why you moved to where you are.
Right.
So you don't have to deal with this
shit. Yes. And I'm like,
dude, living out there in the middle of the woods or something?
Well, I have an idea where he lives. So I open the door and I'm like, hey man, what's going on? He's like, and he just looks zooted. Like he's like, I'm supposed to meet somebody. And I'm like, who are you meeting? And he's like, I don't know their name. And I'm like, all right, well, they're not here. He's like, oh, okay. And so he kind of walks off and starts like again, like, you see those videos on YouTube of the dudes that are hammered and they're like, they can barely stand straight.
So is he crazy and or high and or drunk?
So I'm like, where do you live, man? And he's like, over there. So I'm like, Okay.
That narrows it down.
Yeah, well, it kind of does, though, really, my neighbor, because he pointed in a direction where there's only two homes between there and the street.
Yeah.
And I know the prospector, so you know what I mean?
Did he bring up the letter again this time?
No, he literally said, I'm meeting someone, I don't know their name. I said, where do you live? He pointed over there and left.
He's meeting them at your house?
So where you think he lives, though, is that access from your street, or is it like from off?
No, he's coming out of the woods.
Well, his home, his driveway, you can get to on my street. Okay. But, yes, he's legitimately just walking through the woods. And I have him on, like, our Nest camera, and he's, like, comes out of the woods and walks right and walks around and then just...
Are you staying cool during all this?
Yeah, I mean, yes.
I feel like you should be, like, I see you being, like, get the hell off my lawn, like,
yeah, but
coming
does
out
that
with
just,
a...
No.
Well, obviously, does that aggravate?
That comes to, like, comes down to sort of, like, his persona. You know
yeah.
what I mean? Like, a little bit of the way he's, like, not really threatening in any way. He just... I don't know if he's coming like he's a heroin addict and he wants needs money. You're coming to my back door.
He could
and
he
wants
asked.
To get in.
Look, yeah, but he could be scoping.
But no, not asking anything. I'm saying like yeah. he's scoping the house to break
that's
in
what,
to get something to steal.
Yeah.
Because you know what I mean.
Yeah.
Like that's what I'm saying.
It could be an act too.
Yes,
like
absolutely.
He could just be like, all right, this house is in the middle of the woods. I'm gonna play the crazy guy.
Do the spin.
Ailey's handling it the coolest way he can in his underwear.
Well,
with
in all reality, and so my question to you is.
Might want to notify the cops.
That was going to that's my
oh,
question.
Sorry.
Do I just go talk to the parents or do I call the police?
Do you know the parents?
I already did one of these, so I wanted to get your take
on
it.
Do you know it?
I've never met any of them in my life ever.
But do you when he says when he points and says I live over here, do you think he's being truthful?
Yes, because
okay.
The only reason I probably didn't say it. The only reason I have an idea of who he is because I'm one of those people that's super observant, so I know who drives what in my neighborhood.
Right. Yeah.
I know, like, and I've talked to the prospector, and he's mentioned that there's a kid around this age over here.
I would have.
So I'm like, okay, it's probably this kid. You know what I mean? And
I would have
100%. Saying kid. Bitch is 30.
I would have 100% knocked on the door that I think it is because – it's more important for me to have that part of the mystery solved than to get the cops involved. Like, I need to know where
okay,
this
no,
kid
no, no.
is.
Okay, no. Let me rephrase. I don't mean cops involved, like, go to their house. I mean, like, do you call the cops just to, like, say, hey, just so you know, this happened. I don't need you going knocking on doors, but if something does happen, like, you need to know that this has happened.
Here's a lead.
Like,
you should document this in case you
that's
have to
the whole
pop
thing. It's
this
more the
guy.
Documentation.
Yeah, yeah,
it's like, if
right.
I end up killing this dude in the middle of the night, they could be what do you mean he's come by before? No, he hasn't.
Yeah. We don't have any record.
Right,
of that,
exactly. So
I don't think it's an either or. It's both.
It which could is be what both. I ended up doing. I did both.
Yeah, but I would have started with the – I would have first – my first inclination would have been go to the house.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Just
so
to establish
I will tell you,
if
I was
there.
Getting apprehensive because I'm like, all right, what if this whole
crazy?
Fucking family – are fucking rockheads, and they freak out and pull a gun because they feel like I'm going to bring the cops to them.
Yeah.
I'm like, I'm going to this fucking crack house, and maybe I shouldn't. Maybe I should just call the cops. So then I was like, fuck it, I'm going to talk to them. I pull in the driveway.
I hope you were strapped.
I wasn't. I pull in the driveway, and I fucking cannot explain to you the insanity of what I saw with this house.
Oh, what?
Mind-blowing. You remember the house and the people from the Burbs, the Klopeks?
Of course.
It was fucking just like that. When I tell you this,
holes in the yard,
I'm not lying
random
to you in any way, shape, or form. The front grass was 8 feet tall.
Holy shit.
And there's no walkway to the house. 8 foot tall grass.
Oh, no.
All you can see through the grass is the ceiling fans on the porch. I had to yell at the front, say, is anyone in there? Beat out car, smash back window with... 65 bottles on the back of the trunk of the car.
Oh, my God.
The whole ground trash filled with for 40 yards as far as you can see where they've been walking on it for fucking years.
Wow.
Over on the left.
What the?
30 bags of trash that had just been thrown over there, sprawled out. And I'm like, I did come to a fucking rock house.
You did.
Now I'm in trouble. So I'm like, holy fuck. And I'm like, I'm pot committed, though. I can't just leave now.
Yeah.
So,
dude.
This is today, by the way.
Oh, God.
Yeah, this happened today.
Oh, that's why you were late.
So I'm like, hello? And the guy's like, who's there? And I tell him who I was. He comes out, and he may be the single grimiest human being I've ever seen in my life.
Wow.
No, I'm not. Every single fingernail on his hand was 3/4 of an inch long.
Ugh.
Fucking dirt and brown under all of them.
Oh,
wife beater and just the grimiest shit you've ever seen.
Yeah.
And I'm like, hey, man, here's the deal.
This sounds like a nightmare.
Yeah, this sounds
the thing is,
awful.
I'm pretending like I don't know that it's his son.
Yeah.
I'm like, this guy came, here's a video from my nest. He's like, oh, yeah, that's so-and-so. I'm like, well, here's the deal, man. I have a dog.
Yeah.
I have kids. If this, you know, I'm going to call the police, or God forbid he comes with my wife by herself.
Yeah.
Or at night, we're going to arm ourselves. You need to, like,
corral this dude.
Work this out. You know what I mean?
So you let him know, like,
oh, absolutely.
We have guns over there. Yes. I don't want an accident to happen.
Yeah.
Kind of.
In all reality, he really is lucky that he has not gone. When our dog is out, a lot of the time, majority of the time, our dog's roaming the woods and would not take kindly at all to a motherfucker coming through those woods. That's just the way she's wired.
Oh, you know, no, yeah, I mean? Your dog doesn't play.
So, and he's like, oh, he's got this mental issue, this and that. And
you're like, no
what?
Shit.
Right. Yeah. He's got meds. And
you're like, hold on. Let me sit down in this broken lawn chair.
Right. Yeah. Exactly.
Anything left in those bottles?
I'm sit on your gas can you have sitting next to me.
You know, but the county has ordinances against that shit. Like,
yeah, that's a health.
They can, like, you
dude,
can call
they need
them.
To.
Like,
it is the worst shit I've seen. It's like from the fucking show Hoarders. It's just like that. And the house. I'm
which
showing
means,
you a picture when we get off the
that
air.
That means
here.
They have mental issues too.
Or obviously. They're all fucking.
Oh, they, yeah.
That's
they,
I mean.
They
all
yeah.
have mental issues. So he's like, he's
I don't
looking,
know if mental issues. I don't know if he's just a rockhead, and the dad's saying he has mental issues, so he doesn't know that he doesn't want to tell me that his kid's a rockhead.
Yeah,
you know what I mean.
Either way, it's not a good.
He has a
situation.
Mental issue. It's just whether it's self-induced or it's like.
Yeah.
You know they all mean? Have mental issues.
Yes.
You don't pile up trash and let the lawn grow 8 feet
that's
tall.
A feat to get your yard to 8 feet.
8 feet?
Is hard.
I was like, yeah. I've never seen that. I've seen some knee-high shit, but who has 8 foot tall fucking grass?
Yeah,
damn.
Normally the shit gets up to a foot, foot and a half, it starts falling over.
Right.
Like,
yeah.
He's got, like,
they
got
to water it.
Yeah.
Like, they've had to actually work at that.
Oh, my God.
I think I got a future listing in my.
Now
you do.
And now you're like,
if you want a flipper, I think I found one.
Now you're like, maybe I need to go back to an HOA.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, oh, that's why we have the HOA.
Yeah. But I did call the cops, though, and I was like, look, I don't need you going out there. I just want you to know that this shit happened. Write it down because, you know.
How do the cops react when you tell them something like that?
Oh, yeah, we come across these crazy people all the time, hopped up on something. You can't talk to them because they don't know. They don't even. You could tell them that stop sign is invisible, and they believe you. It's like shit, like the cops are like, oh, yeah. And she's
great.
Like, I work the south side of Chesterfield. Let me talk to the guys in the west because generally we know these people.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
I'm like, okay, cool.
Oh, yeah, so. This guy's been.
Right.
Someone's talked to this kid.
And I did talk to my neighbor who's like the second in command of Chesterfield fire department.
Uh-huh.
And he was like, yeah, he like was bringing my paper to the door. Like he would go in my mailbox, grab my paper and bring it to the door for me. And, like, I had to have a talk with him, like, don't fucking do that.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So,
I mean,
words out about this dude.
That
apparently.
Is seriously, like, get shot.
That's the thing,
like,
is, like, you have to be thankful that I'm not a crazy person.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
If I was a fucking animal or a mean person, like, the plenty of people on our road, they would have not have been as nice. You know what I mean? You would have been fucking.
You could very
this
well.
This is Sparta. You would have gotten kicked off the fucking. You know what I mean?
This is Sparta.
Yeah.
You could have very well just. Unloaded a clip through your back door at 7
Absolutely.
In the morning and been like, I did not feel safe.
Yeah.
Like, this
That's
guy came
messed
out
up.
Of
all this guy wants to do is bring you your paper and he's letting you know about letters.
Exactly.
These guys are super helpful.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
You should have seen, I'm just looking at Angela and we're just sipping our coffee in the morning. She's like, hun? I'm like, what? She's like, hun? I'm like, oh, there's a dude walking up to our back door.
Good thing
in the woods.
Good thing I'm wearing my good underwear.
If you live in the woods, you're never like, someone's going to walk through the woods to my house. That's fucking takes you back. You're like, dude.
Yeah. That's some
is this
like,
going down right now?
That's some Dateline shit.
Yes, it is. So that was my day.
Wow, dude.
Yeah.
I'm not too excited about that.
No.
Interesting.
That is not. I mean, I know you could take care of
yourself.
Is
that why you called me this morning?
I did. That's exactly why I called you. I wanted to be like, hey, do I call the cops or do I just go talk to the parents?
Yeah, because you called and I was on a WebEx and I'm like looking. I was like.
That's when I was having the mental debate as to whether or not I should, you know. In my head, I was like, they're just going to be standoffish and like, fuck you.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It could get bad. And I was like, maybe I should just call the fuzz and have them.
Or maybe I'll just call Brennan and we'll take care of it.
You know, if Ely calls you, like, I'm actually surprised you didn't answer. Like,
I was on a WebEx with
if
like,
Ely calls me.
I knew. It was 9:02. I was like, every busy human on the planet has a conference call at 9 a.m.
Yeah, and I was on it.
I was off
so
today.
I texted
oh, really?
Yeah, you could have called me.
I was like on a call, and then I didn't even get a chance to call you back till like in the p.m.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Which I was on a call.
Yeah. So I figured. And then I was like, well, I'll see him tonight.
Yeah. But that was interesting.
Wow, yeah. Dude. Well, I'm glad it's you because I know you can take care of yourself. But yeah, that's scary, dude. I mean, you got young kids. And you got a wife. Like,
yeah.
F all that, dude. And you wonder why people get shot. I mean, really.
Yeah, legitimately.
He's just got a publisher's clearinghouse letter in his hand. He's laying there bleeding.
You won.
Right.
But where Ely lives is where people that don't want to have people around, and they are armed. Like, that's
absolutely.
Like, you can,
you're flirting with danger.
Brendan, your neighborhood, my neighborhood, you could walk into somebody's backyard, knock on the back door, and they'd be like, "What's up, neighbor?" Like, even if they don't know you, but you go out there where people have acres and acres of land.
Oh, they feel like they need to help you. If I rolled up on a neighbor's house, they'd be like, "What's wrong?"
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, that's honestly the flip side of me trying to go to their house. I'm like, I'm about to do the same thing that he technically just did to me.
Yeah.
I'm going to this person's home.
Yeah, but you're going to the Klopek's house to do it.
Right. Exactly. You know what I mean? But
sketchier.
I'm like,
yeah, but you're like announcing yourself as you walk
but
up.
But it's still, it is weird that this day and age, 20 years ago, none of us would have given a fuck about it or said a word about it. But the fact that I'm second guessing going to someone's house because of this world we live in and how awkward it is, that's weird to me.
Yeah,
you know
that
I mean?
Used to be how it was done.
That's what I'm saying.
You
no one gave
on a dorm.
Yeah.
Hey, I just want to ask you a question, or can I borrow a cup of freaking sugar?
Right.
I mean, that was pretty normal. Yeah.
And that's what my thing was like. If you want to borrow sugar or have a beer, come down the fucking driveway an old human in a car.
He's just I need to take a bath. Can I borrow your hot tub?
Yeah, exactly.
That's the shady part. Coming out of the woods is the really scary part.
Absolutely.
If I saw you coming down the driveway, I'd be like, all right, this guy needs
something. Why would he come down the driveway? You know how difficult it is to get down driveways? 8 feet of grass. You're better off going around through the woods.
Right. I guess he's doing the shortest point, A to B, through the woods.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
Yeah, but you got to think, they think differently. He probably is no, it's going to be all overgrown, but I can see that it's an easy path through the woods.
How far is it through the woods from your house to his house? I mean, obviously, you probably never walked that.
I would say probably 200, 300 yards.
Yeah, I mean, that's a good height.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, so that was my drama today.
That changes your perception of kind of what your neighborhood looks like. You didn't even know you had that.
Yeah, no clue.
I would have opened the door with my piece tucked in my undies and been like, can I help you,
Well,
sir?
Next time, I told Angel, next time we're going to not answer. I'm going to see what he does and just watch him through the windows in the house. You know what I mean?
Yeah, see if he does try to come in, start jiggling.
If he's good at scoping you out, he should already know you guys are home all the time. Like, that's not the house to go into.
And that's the thing is, if you watch the nest video, it's clear that it's almost like he's not doing something nefarious. He literally is just walk up to the door, knocks on the door. Like, I'm here to see my buddy. Like, it's the weirdest thing ever.
What's his name? I don't know.
Yeah, exactly.
So he's come up twice?
Yes.
Has it always been the same time of the day?
No. Just 7 a.m. was today.
Right.
Jacob off the bus. 4 p.m. was the last time.
Oh, okay.
Rocked
that
out
is
at
weird.
7 a.m. Who the fuck, dude?
But that is weird because that's good, scoping out.
It is.
It's like, have they left at 7? Are they home at 4? Like, I'm narrowing the window down here. Right.
That is how you do
Which is what I don't know. Pardon me.
I'm paranoid about that kind of stuff, though, because I'm like, it doesn't take – there's cars parked up all up and down my street, and it doesn't take a genius to watch – my wife get in the car and leave, and me get in my car and leave, and you're like, well, the house is empty.
Absolutely.
And if he's sitting in the woods, it's pretty easy to see.
And based on the description, he's either doing one of two things. He's either looking for the money to do something more, or he's, completely starving.
It's either one of two things. He's either legitimately has no clue where he is on the planet, or he's trying to figure out if he can get in there and get some money. That's really the only two options in my mind.
I'm thinking he's just nuts. I think there's a history of mental illness in the house. I think he's got whatever that is. And if the dude is pointing with his long fingernails and grime under him, that one's crazy.
Yeah.
He might just be that crazy.
Yeah, for sure.
And he may be harmless crazy, but I have a real hard time trusting harmless crazy.
I was going to say, to me, harmless crazy is just one, push from going.
That's what I'm saying. That's
off the rails.
I always look. That's why that guy at the bus stop who keeps coming up telling the CIA stories, I understand he's harmless crazy today, but I'm always keeping an eye on him.
Yes,
I don't trust him one bit. I haven't even let him see which way, because I know he knows I have kids. I haven't even let him see which house I'm in or which street I turn on.
Does he have kids, or what is he doing out there? Is he a kid?
No, he's just an old man who walks around and talks about how his daughter's in the CIA and he doesn't get to see her, but he also
knows. Why is he at the bus stop?
He just walks. I actually had a neighbor talk to me the other day and said that you know, a couple people have like called the police. The police are fully aware of it. They've gone over there and talked to him, and they're like, look.
But in reality, it's probably just some old dude who's, you know.
He's just crazy.
Looking after him, and they're like, sorry, Steve got out again.
Yeah.
And that's it. And they,
or he goes walking at that time because people are out, and he's like.
He likes to have that talk.
Yeah, I'm tired of sitting at house by myself.
I've been in COVID for a fucking year. I'm going to get to the bus stop and talk to this dude Kennedy.
Exactly.
Yeah, but that's his thing. He goes out, and he apparently he has a couple different routes he walks.
Yeah.
During that time. And so I'm always a little nervous.
Just we're talking like 70?
We'll call it a haggard 60. You know how that looks like 70?
Yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah.
I see you call it a haggard 60.
I'm with you.
But he's like physically not good either. Like, you're
I'd
not
whoop
really.
I'd whoop his ass.
No, I'm saying, are you, like, you don't think the girl, like, he couldn't scoop the girls up? Like,
he doesn't have a vehicle of any kind. Yeah. I doubt he can drive. I mean, yeah, I would think that.
You could catch him.
I could catch him. I also don't think that he could physically. Like scoop them up and run.
Yeah,
like he's a weird dude though, man. And I don't trust him.
There's a lot of weirdos out there, man.
I understand he's harmless, but I don't like him. I don't like him around.
No,
is he nice or creepy?
He's creepy.
Really?
He tells the same story every time you see him. Like, you know, he's one of those. It's just like.
So you wouldn't just chalk it up to early onset and just keep moving about your day? Like, you're really bugged by him? Like, I think if I saw an old man who was clearly demented or doing something like that.
But the stories he tells are weird about his daughter being in the CIA and killing a bunch of people, but yet he doesn't know where she is.
Yeah,
like, it's all like, it's all like
over and over again.
You're a flat earther, you know, like he's a conspiracy theory guy. Like,
I gotcha.
But it's always the same story. It's always just a mild deviation in the way he's telling the same story about how his daughter's
in the CIA. We said it earlier, it was like Groundhog Day for this guy. Like, he's doing this. He wakes up and it's just kind of.
And he tells the same story to everybody. Like, when I talk to the neighbor.
Yeah, so why I would find that odd that would bother you.
It's just weird because my kids could be out there alone and this dude is creepy. That's what I'm saying. There's a mental illness thing there, and I just don't.
Yeah, but like immediately I would default to this is an old dude who's got early onset. I wouldn't default to like this guy's creepy and snatching a kid.
To me, it would be both. I would be like, he's crazy. Well, I wouldn't want my
kid. Be like, that's someone's granddad just wanted like to walk.
Well. Even if it's not, like, worst-case scenario murder situation, like, I wouldn't want my kids walking up and being, like, the old guy talking crazy to them. Like,
it's always the same story, which is not an Alzheimer's thing. Like, I've lived with Alzheimer's.
I mean, it could be dementia or whatever.
But I think it's a mental illness that's not Alzheimer's.
I got
you. There's something else there because he's always telling – he's stuck in a loop.
Yeah.
Alzheimer's, like, you forget your loop.
Yeah.
You start a new loop.
Yeah, yeah.
He's always in the same loop.
Yeah, I said, like, he's going to get to the end of the story, and you find out that his daughter died. And he's, as a tragic event, he's just reliving the same day.
Yeah, he's in Inception right now.
Yeah. Stuck. It's a little odd.
Well, you said it real quick, bus stop. I know it's the last day of school. Did you guys do any of the stuff that I drove around today, and I see all the parents out there. I mean, I did it when my kids were younger, but it's the last day of school. Kids are getting off the bus stop and water balloons and streamers and all
that. We've
done
that years past, but it got canceled last year and then didn't get picked up again this year.
I felt bad, man. My oldest daughter's leaving elementary school, and she came off the bus, and I was like, I ran up and I got up there, and I was like, yeah, what's up? I was like, summer break. You know, like, in my mind, this is a great thing.
Yeah.
What is better than summer break?
Yeah.
And she comes off the bus and just starts bawling and runs over and falls in my arms. And I was like, oh, what's this? And she's like, I'm never going back there again. Like, no, I just. And I'm like, well, are you nervous about the next phase or are you sad looking back? And she's like, I'm just sad looking back. Like, I won't get to go back there. She's like, I liked it there.
Yeah.
You know, I had fun there. I learned there. I made friends there. That was my school.
Same thing for my oldest today. Like, he was sad. Like, he was. I mean, he did 6 years at that school. Like, he's had. You know, the same teachers a couple times. Like, it's, you know, it's all he's ever known.
So our kids are all the same age, and Jacob just did the same thing today. But he had, like, a lot of parties to let him not think about it. There was, like, there's a big.
Yeah, she had a great day.
Last day of school, but I mean, after school. Like, there was, like, a big party in Summer Lake they were throwing down and barbecue.
We had a pool party a couple weeks ago. They haven't done any schooling in weeks. So,
but, like, no, they haven't. They've been screwing up. They've been leaving with Nintendo Switches in the morning. I'm like, what are you doing?
It hurt. It was harder for me because I walk my kids to school and walk them home. Not every
day.
That'll
hit you.
But, like, I never had that growing up, so that was always special to me. Like,
heck
and now I don't get to walk both of them to school anymore. Like, the older one will be gone early in the morning. But I'm excited for him to meet new kids, trying for to sure. You know, be put in a new yeah. challenge, and I'm excited there for was my a time young one you to be nervous. The big guy.
Yeah, there's a time when you were nervous about this school.
Yeah.
You
know, oh, right? Absolutely. So. I honestly, I didn't even realize I was sad till she was sad.
Yeah.
And then I was like, oh yeah. Okay, yeah. I was excited for them. I was like, we're going to the pool. Like,
right.
It was in my yeah. mentality.
Yeah, you're like, middle school, what? And they're like, no.
Yeah, like, I don't want that. Yeah. So.
Well, middle school is the worst for everybody.
Middle school sucks.
Yeah, I don't know anyone who enjoyed middle school.
And it's really hard for girls, too, from what I understand.
Yes, oh, absolutely. Dude, especially with technology. Way worse for girls.
Yes.
Oh, God, technology.
Yeah. I'm dreading that whole
thing. Plus, it's the whole big dog, now you're the small. Now you're yep. you know,
yeah.
bottom
starting
of the totem
back
pole.
Over. Yeah.
Which I get. I have one kid who's now about to be at the top of the totem pole.
Yeah.
So I'm like, oh, snap. So, like, the other one's crying. I'm, like, hitting her. I'm like, yo, dude, you made it.
Yeah.
Time to mess up those nerds.
For Jacob, you got to go beat up the biggest eighth grader you can possibly.
Yeah, go. Yeah. Good luck with that.
That's find right. the biggest guy.
Pick the kid with the mustache and yeah. clock him in his nose.
Right. Except that kid's 6 foot, 200
exactly.
pounds.
Exactly.
For sure. Run the 4.4.
And, yeah. and he's 20.
Yeah.
He lives in the woods.
For those of you who know my younger son, last night I said, oh, man, tomorrow will be the last day, you know. Next year you'll be the big guy in the family. He goes, who says I wasn't the big guy in the family at the school anyway?
That's awesome.
And that's the
like,
attitude, right?
Yes,
like, he's going to be just fine.
Like, yeah, you're right. You probably were.
He's going to be just fine.
Yes, he is.
Well, it's exciting, man. I'm happy for the kids. I am disgusted by the whole like graduation thing. That makes me want
to
puke.
Dude, I had to. My wife was like, she's like, we're going to get her a gift, and I was like. For doing the minimum, you know, like
right,
and then she was like, "Hey, we're getting a yard sign. We're gonna put it out there." And I was like, "We should get yard signs for every time they complete a meal."
Yeah.
Like right. my minimum expectation was get through elementary school.
Did your school give them to you? Because our school gave
yeah,
every
they
fifth
gave
grader
them to us.
Yard
so now
sign.
It's in my
yeah.
now it's in my yard.
I'm like, that's a good use of funds,
right?
Yeah, it's ridiculous. Yeah, my wife was making a big deal out of it. Like, we got to get her a gift. What should we get her?
You don't have to.
I was like, I don't know. Why are we getting her a gift?
Yeah.
I was like, I.
You're expected to graduate fifth grade.
When I graduated high school, I yeah. netted $100.
Oh, really? That's all?
That was it. Yeah, apparently. Like,
I got a bunch of money.
And everyone else did, but in my small universe, it just wasn't a big thing. Like, it was kind of expected, I guess.
Yeah.
And so now we're giving a gift. I was like, come on. Fifth grade?
Yeah.
You didn't get out of fifth grade. You don't even amount to much in the
1920s. I wouldn't say. Yeah. I'm like, yeah. I totally agree with no gift for fifth grade. I can see parents being a little bit more wanting to give something because of this particular past year, but at the same time, like,
but
I'm
that's not what it is.
I know, but at the same time, like, I wouldn't give you a gift because you were in bed all day learning.
Yeah,
you didn't have to go to school. You get less of a gift.
This whole thing was funky, man. Whole thing was funky. But
for
hey,
sure.
Congratulations to everyone who did graduate this year.
Yeah,
good
well,
stuff.
This generation, this is their second graduation because they graduated preschool too, so they're getting used to it.
Yeah, there was a day, there was pomp and circumstance there.
Oh yeah, you.
Yeah.
Every time I see the preschoolers in the cap and gown, I just want to like start punting people, dude.
So
it's like
real quick.
Yeah.
Like you literally could have shit in your pants every day. They still let you out. Yeah. You made it.
Right. Yeah.
Dude, that's how fifth grade
Jeffrey
is.
Ate all of his glue every day.
Congratulations. Yeah.
No, but real quick, I had, as you guys may have known, back in the day, I had a part-time job driving a limousine. And
yes.
One gig, I got booked, and I drove to this lady's house over in Bonaire, and
with
she
your
said,
Samsonite briefcase?
Yeah, exactly.
I was way off.
It's okay. I'm a limo driver.
It was.
It's full of IOUs.
Yeah, that's a so car.
I had no clue. I had no clue what the event was for. I pulled up to the house. It's got this huge circle driveway in front, big old steps coming down the front of the house. And she says, I said, well, I'm here with James River. You know, what am I doing? Where are we going? We got 3 hours booked. She says, oh, take the car and pull it around the back of the house. Take the car, pull it around the back of the house, and I park it there. Then all these parents start showing up, and all these kindergartners
oh, come on.
Get there.
That's
she puts out
awful.
She puts out a red carpet on the driveway and a podium. The kids
dude.
Go out the back of the door and get in the limousine.
You should have rolled that fucking
she's
limo,
got,
dude.
She's got
yeah.
seats
right.
in the front of the yard for all the parents, and all I did was the kids in the car. I drove literally 50 feet from behind the house up to the side of the driveway, red carpet, and the lady on the podium calls out the
they
graduates.
They take pictures like it was
like
red carpet.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh
she says,
God.
You know, Sammy.
Where was this?
This was When?
Where?
Oh, over in Bonaire. I mean, like in the one of the Victorian
like
houses,
old Bonaire.
Yeah, old Bonaire. But it, she was like, oh, so-and-so graduated. And the kid would get out, walk up, get a little diploma.
Those
parents clapped it again.
Those kids are ruined.
Smoke up, Johnny.
Yeah.
That's what you should have given him.
Stu, you put 10 miles on the Carden height. What the hell, dude?
They gave me, I mean, I got a good tip out of it. I was like, she's like, can you, at the end of it, she's like, can you take all the kids for a lap around the neighborhood?
Yeah. Do you have to put booster seats all along it?
Yeah.
Dude, I had some teachers tell me yesterday that, like, one of them was saying they can't give anything lower than a 50 in their class, and, like, one said they're leaving their job with whatever county because they were told they can't fail anyone. Like, they're pushing. Yeah. And, like, one of the teachers was like, yeah, we can't fail a bunch of kids because then it'll back the system up. I'm like, that's great. Right. And then it's called backing the system up when they're all out of high school and nobody's capable of
working. What does it do
to
the system when they're 30?
Yeah, you're backing
the fact that they
up.
Call it a system is a problem.
Well, yeah, exactly. Congrats on your graduations.
Yes, but no, congratulations
well-deserved.
To everybody who graduated something difficult.
Yes.
Nice. I'm sure there's deserving people. Yes. And all of our kids, super deserving. Mm-hmm. No, it's awesome. Thank you guys so much for tuning in.
No problem.
We'll be
glad I could be here.
Yeah.
Troy, you really livened up that second half.
I do. That's what I do. I'm a closer.
I like that. I like that about you.
Bullpen.
You guys haven't had a chance to find us on Facebook. Please do. Like, if you like and rate. Obviously, wherever it is you get podcasts from, it helps us in whatever algorithm you're listening to. And if you want to get a chance to send us some topics, you can do so at InsideThePalletHouse@gmail.com. And if you got too much money, Troy will accept it.
Yep, at Venmo at InsideThePalletHouse.
You can always find us on Instagram and Twitter at ITPHPodcast. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. We'll talk to you next week. Cheers.
You can always rate and subscribe.
It would help.
Give us a review. That always helps.
Peace out.
Cheers.
Peace out.
That was a pretty good podcast once I showed up.
Ha! There it is.